Wicca Crystal Magic, the ultimate beginner's guide to master the use of crystals in spells and rituals, and benefit from them while understanding their role in Wiccan history and witchcraft. Written by the Wiccan Man. Narrated by Jim D. Johnston. Table of Contents. Introduction. Chapter 1. The World of Crystals. Chapter 2. Welcoming Crystals into Your Life. Chapter 3. What Affects Crystal Power? Chapter 4. Crystals in Ritual. Chapter 5. Crystal Spells. Closure. Disclaimer. This document is geared towards providing exact and reliable information in regards to the topic and issue covered. The publication is sold with the idea that the publisher is not required to render accounting, officially permitted, or otherwise qualified services. If advice is necessary, legal or professional, a practiced individual in the profession should be ordered. From a declaration of principles which was accepted and approved equally by a committee of the American Bar Association and a committee of publishers and associations. In no way is it legal to reproduce, duplicate, or transmit any part of this document in either electronic means or in printed format. Recording of this publication is strictly prohibited, and any storage of this document is not allowed unless with written permission from the publisher. All rights reserved. The information provided herein is stated to be truthful and consistent in that any liability, in terms of inattention or otherwise, by any usage or abuse of any policies or directions contained within, is the solitary and utter responsibility of the recipient reader. Under no circumstances will any legal responsibility or blame be held against the publisher for any reparation, damages, or monetary loss due to the information herein, either directly or indirectly. Respective authors own all copyrights not held by the publisher. The information herein is offered for informational purposes solely and is universal as so. The presentation of the information is without contract or any type of guarantee assurance. The trademarks that are used are without any consent, and the publication of the trademark is without permission or backing by the trademark owner. All trademarks and brands within this book are for clarifying purposes only and are owned by the owners themselves, not affiliated with this document. Introduction. We know that people have used crystal for magic, healing, decoration, protection, and in religious ceremonies for about 20,000 years. Early man was probably instinctively drawn to precious stones, possibly because of their vibrant color, which they recognized as a source of powerful energy. They tapped into this energy for both healing and spiritual purposes. It's fascinating to think that the early man's fascination with crystals continues to this day. Although crystals are nothing more than very old pieces of rock, still, they are living organisms with a life energy of their own. This energy produces vibrations which give each crystal a specific frequency. The frequency may or may not match your own, and this is why you like some crystals more than others, although preference may change over time. Whether you're aware of it or not, when you find a crystal that you like very much, what is actually happening is that you have come across a stone whose energy matches your own. If you're sad, you'll probably choose a blue crystal, while hyperactive people, or those who feel they need an energy boost, usually go for strong colors, such as red. However, your energy fluctuates during the day and throughout your lifetime, so it's not unusual that at different stages of your life, or even a day, you feel more attracted to certain types of crystal or to certain colors. Although we still can't explain scientifically how mystic healing works or why crystals enhance spell work, We know that they do. Using a stone you can align your own energy with enables you to harness the healing and spiritual powers of crystal. Whether you use them for healing, spell work, jewelry, or to decorate your home with, crystals add magic to your life. Although they cannot heal or create magic on their own, they promote self-healing and help you tap into your subconscious, which is where magic actually takes place. Subtle energies given off by crystals are not easy to measure, which is why modern science rejects the possibility that crystals may possess healing and spiritual properties. While it's true that crystals cannot make you a better person or heal a disease, they do help you grow spiritually, which indirectly makes you a better person, and they do successfully restore balance within a body, which eventually helps you heal. Coming from deep inside the earth, these beautiful, vibrant stones have a lot to teach you if you learn how to tap into their mystical powers. Chapter 1. The World of Crystals. What is crystal? Crystals are pieces of rock created millions of years ago, deep inside the earth. They were forced to grow under tremendous pressure and heat for millions of years. They come in many forms, shapes, and colors, and each possesses a unique energy and quality. When referring to crystals, we interchangeably use terms such as rocks, gemstones, minerals, or crystals, although they are not the same thing. Minerals are what rocks are made of, and some of the most common ones are quartz, fluorite, gypsum, and so forth. Crystals were once liquid particles, which, over millions of years, solidified into what we now know as amethyst, carnelian, lapis lazuli, moonstone, and so forth. Rocks are a combination of one or more minerals, or may not contain minerals at all. They can be igneous, such as granite, sedimentary, such as limestone, or metamorphic, such as marble. Gemstones, also known as precious stones, are mineral crystals which can be divided into precious, diamond, ruby, sapphire, and so forth, and semi-precious, opal, topaz, carnelian, and so forth. Crystals are more part of our lives than we realize. We wear them as jewelry, use them for healing and spell work, keep them in our homes to enhance the positive energy, and rulers wear them in their crowns for protection. Not to mention that we also find them in salt, sugar, and snowflakes. While today crystals are mainly used in technology, in the past it was the healing and magical powers of crystal that made it such a valuable stone to have. Crystals are also distinguished by their shape. They are available as processed, such as tumbled stones and cut crystals, or in their natural formations, like clusters, wands, and phantoms. For example, mineralogical samples are crystals still on their rock base, that is, in the form in which they were found. Crystal clusters are a number of crystals sharing a common base. Single crystals are recognized by their geometric shapes. Tumbled stones are damaged crystals polished by gravels. Crystals in technology. The main use of crystals today is in technology. However, for millions of people throughout the world, crystals are a powerful healing tool which helps them relieve various mental and emotional problems, or achieve inner peace and spiritual balance. Crystals in technology. Crystals play a very important role in electronics and optical industries, and we now know that technological development without crystals would not be possible. Crystals produce an electrical charge when compressed, and this has had a wide application in industry, such as in the production of record player needles or various measuring devices. Besides, crystals have the power to carry information, something without which we wouldn't be able to produce silicon chips for computers. Some of the products that crystals are used for: solar cells. They power various instruments, from calculators to space vehicles. Transistors. Based on the same types of materials and crystals as solar cells, transistors can regulate electron flow and amplify radio signals, and hence act as digital switches. Liquid crystals. used for wristwatches, and some types of clocks and pocket calculators. Protean structures. Crystals help solve different protean structure, which is very useful in biochemistry. Pencils. Graphite in a pencil is a type of crystal. Computer chips. Silicons are the basis for all microelectronics, such as computer chips. Optical equipment. Certain optical equipment is made from crystals. CDs and DVDs. Crystalline solids in CDs and DVDs enable us to write and store information on them. Crystals in metaphysics. Metaphysics is concerned with issues which cannot be proven scientifically, nor measured in any way. It can refer to healing, psychic development, meditation, shamanism, witchcraft, angels, ghosts, and so forth. It approaches all the mysteries of this world with an open mind, emphasizing the power of mindset. Topics explored by metaphysics include psychic development, spiritual growth, meditation, working with angels and spirit guides, astral and out-of-body traveling, divination systems such as tarot, astrology, and numerology, the power of crystals, feng shui, past life regression, alternative healing, the law of attraction. Crystals play a significant role in most of these disciplines. As some of them address abstract concepts, they require raised consciousness and a positive mindset, and some of the crystals are known to improve your self-awareness. In ancient cultures, as well as in the New Age movement, crystals are treated as living organisms that possess energies which can be harnessed and used to improve our physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being. Some of the ways in which crystals are used in metaphysics. The shape of crystal and its use in spell work. Abundance crystals are large crystals with an abundance of small crystals clustered around their base. In spell work, you will use this type of crystal for abundant spells when you want to increase something, such as money, luck, and so forth. Clusters are a group of crystals that have grown together on the same base. Symbolically, this kind of crystal symbolizes community. In spell work, you can use cluster crystal to address issues concerning cooperation, harmony, union, and friendship. Channeling crystals are clear quartz crystals which have at least one large, seven-sided face on one side of their tip, and the triangular, three-sided face on the other. This kind of crystal is usually used as a focal point for meditation. It's known to be able to enhance inspiration and insight, so it can be used in spells to help someone who has become stuck and whose creative juices have run dry.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.